So how is the grassroots program in BFC? Because, you know, I think you all are very strong in the grassroots program, and you believe, you being the technical director and youth development head, and your philosophy is to develop your grassroots, right? So how strong is the grassroots program in Bangalore?
We really focused a lot on our grassroots development. You know, maybe in another 4-5 years, we want to have more talent from our local, from Bangalore. So we have a under 17, we have a under 9, then we have a under 11 team, then 13 and 15. And all these teams, they are selected from the soccer schools. The local boys who are with, we have some 16 centers all over Bangalore. And we select the best from there. And then it's not only the best who comes into the academy. And then we have the second best. We have a B team, we have a C team. We see that they also get the games. So just training is not important. It's very important that, you know, we give them more games, because that's where the kids get to, you know, more decision making. Otherwise, in training, it's always the coach who's instructing to do this, do that. But when they play a game, it's them, it's their ideas, what they think and how they have to. So it's very important. Now, last year we started Baby League. So it's a DPDL, double pass baby league. And then Bangalore FC, what we do is we have a school tournament. We have a school tournament for 8, under 8, under 10, under 14, for both boys and girls.
Okay.
So in that also we do scouting. So that's how we try to get the best from Bangalore and put them in the system. So we had Bellary, that's the base for our academy. We had only under 15 and under 18. But since last year, what we did was we started under 13. So they are young boys who are 10 and 11 years old. So you can imagine they will be in our setup for 6, 7, 8 years till they go to the reserve team. If you can't guarantee how many will progress. But yes, we have to work hard, and we sincerely work towards the development of the kids. It's not only that we are, but right now our main focus is to work more on the local kids. So I want to see that another 5 years, I want to have more local players in my team, in Bangalore FC. Because if you see now, we don't even have a single player in the senior team, even the reserve team I don't have. And now what I've done is we have taken few from for under 18. So let's hope they make it to the higher level. You know, but the young lot, the under 7, under 9, and we have real good talents. So I hope they will be our future.
That's nice. So you being the parent and a coach also, so you know, when you said your son also plays for the baby league, right? So, you know, when you go to the ground, there are parents, you know, shouting over there. So how do you handle that? Because you act as a parent over there, or you act as a coach over there?
No, I just be a parent, because I have a coach there. So that's again a lesson for the parents. You know, they can look at me and learn not to give instructions. But at BFC, what we do is we have a lot of interaction with the parents. We educate them. You know, when the game is on, we don't want any parent to say a word. Yes, you can always encourage the kids, but no instructions, no technical instruction from the parents. They can always scream, shout, whatever they want to do, they can do it. But I have seen the other teams, you know, where the parents are, they confuse the kids. They really confuse the kids, because the coach is saying something and the parent, they want something else from the kid. And the kid is just confused. He's looking at his parent, and then he looks at the coach. What I'm supposed to do? So this is what we educate the parents. You know, this when they experience this in the pitch, we have a meeting with them. We tell them, you know, you've seen the other parents how they shout. It becomes difficult for the kid. So now our parents, the kids who are playing, the parents, they know now what they are supposed to do. It not make things difficult for the kids.
Exactly, because you know, we find, you know, then it becomes a problem, you know, in handling the parents and then the kids. Because the parents, kids don't fight. Actually, the parents fight from their outside.
So that's what you know. In grassroots, it's very important. First, we educate the parents. You know, because once they know what is needed, they can educate them. Because most of the time, they are with the parents. They are in school and they are with the parents. They come to us 1 hour, 1 hour, 1.5 hours. That's it. So it's very important we educate the parents so they can give the inputs, because they can always learn. You know, because I'll give you a small example. When there was a match going on, and then what happened was the under nines were playing, and they were leading some 4-5 goals, you know, and then referee made a silly mistake, and all the parents and all started shouting, come out of the ground, you know. So I was there, I told the parents, what you're doing is wrong. Why? Because then what your child is learning is, if you are losing and if referee does something wrong, you have to walk out of the pitch. You know, that's a wrong guidance. So again, the parents, they realized and they asked the kids to go back to the ground, and they requested the coach, let's play. So it was a good thing. Yeah, it was a good thing. So that's very important. How we coaches. I'm sure there must be a lot of coaches who are here. So it's very important. It's very important what instruction, what the way we speak with the kids. They are all taking everything from us. So we have to be positive all the time. We can't be negative, you know. And then at BFC, we are focusing more on the technical part with the kids, because right now we're not going much into tactical part. We are more into technique. So we allow the kids to express, you know, in the game. They want to dribble, they dribble. They want to shoot, they shoot. Whatever they want to do, let them do, you know. But yes, after the game, we show them. We do all the recordings. We show them. Then there's a question session where the kids can understand, you know, why you took a shot. It was an excellent shot, but why you took that shot? It didn't go in the goal. What better could have been done, you know? That way, in that sense, what happens is the kids start learning. So then I was talking to the other coaches, because what happens when they are playing BFC, because they have been winning all the games. So most of the teams, the coaches, what they do is they tell the kids to just clear the ball. So then I had to speak to those coaches, you know, it's not my job, but still I have to tell them, you know, please, the way when you tell the kid just clear the ball, what you're doing is you're putting negative things in the kid. You're telling the kid, you know, the team opponent is good, don't hold the ball, just clear the ball. And then the kid is not learning anything. So it's very important for the kid to hold the ball, to express, to carry, dribble, maybe whatever he wants to do.
And what about the academy players, like your under 17 and under 15? How do you communicate with them time, because it's a residential setup, right?
Yeah. So what we did was, since we got to know the league for junior league, the elite league, the under 18, the under 15, and the under 13, the league, they said it won't happen. So we had to send the boys home. The local boys, they went home. Kerala, they all went home. Only thing is, only place stuck was the Mizorams and the Manipuris, and few from Kolkata. They are stuck here in Bellary, the under 13 and under 15. But we don't want to even send them. The flights are working, everything is fine, but we are very careful about the safety of the kids, because we don't want to take any risk, you know. But still, the parents are worried, you know. We've been telling them this is the safest place for the kids to be, but still, you know, parents, they are really worried. But yes, we have booked the tickets for them, so within a week and 10 days, they will be all going home, because there's no training going on. But yes, what we have done is my reserve team and the under 18, we are club together, who stays in Bangalore, they are with me. So what we have done is we have a group, so we all get in Zoom call. So we have given them off season training. So weekly schedule, we put on the group, we show them the clippings, we show them what has to be done. I have a SNC coach, Ms. Divakar, who handles the whole thing. So he's giving them the training programs, and all the kids are in touch with him, any doubts or whatever. So once they come back in August, I want to see that they all are fit and we can just start. Because it's been 3-4 months, 3 months that they're not been doing much. So it's very important. That's how I'm connected with them, and I'm in touch with them every day.
And what about about the senior team? Like, you know, right now the season is on, or you know, you're waiting for the season to recruit them, or are you continuing with the same players?
No, there are new players who are coming in. There are a few new players, Indians and foreigners as well. I'm sure you can see on Twitter and Insta. All the new players coming in.
Curious to know about it, right?
yeah, of course. Because it's BFC. Yeah, people want to know more about BFC. Yeah. Senior team again. The coach has done the same thing, you know. And I follow him. The senior team is doing the same. We are a strength and condition coach who's also back in Spain. So again, he's given a training program for 6 weeks, you know. So they are going through that. So they all are working out. Maybe in the house or where, whatever small place they get, they can work out. So he's given all the schedule for them. So you don't know when we will start. Now the international flights and all. So when it starts, that's only when the players will start coming. The main is the coach, the boss. He's supposed to be back. Once he's back, then it keeps rolling.
So for the for your BFC players, especially for the reserve team, if any of the player want to give a trial out, what do you think the player needs to have? What do you look into the player? Like, you know, for example, Shiva Shakti, you have taken him from Raman Vijayan Academy, which is again a top over here in Tamil Nadu. And, you know, there are so many articles which has been published, and, you know, and he also said, like, you know, I saw the coach Naushad, that's the reason why I sent my player over there, because I'm very much particular about the coach who's heading over there also. So hats off to you for that. And we generally want to know what exactly, because there are many young players who are, you know, right now being with us. So they exactly want to know, like, what is the thing that they can develop to, you know, get into a professional team?
Yeah. See, you know, BFC, we have a philosophy, you know. So what I need to do is I need to look at the senior team, what the coach wants, what all he looks for in a player. You know, because he's always there for my games, for the under 18 games and for the reserve team games. So that's when he discusses with me everything. You know, he sees any good player and he sees some talent, he's good, but these are the qualities he need to improve on. You know, basically if you see Bangalore FC, they play more ball position. So you want technically good players, technically sound. So it's very important. And it's very important we look for players who are technically good, you know, who's comfortable, who's confident, and who has an attitude. That's the most important thing, you know. He should be eager to play, you know, to perform and to work hard. Again, like you said, I also get many calls, you know, for trials, you know, but again, we have a limitation. I cannot have 100 players being there in my academy, so it's limited to only 20 to 25 players. So still, if you get good talent, so we don't mind extending it to another 2-3 players, not a problem. But again, the competition, we have raised a bar where we look for players. Now if you see Shiv Shakti and all, what I liked about him was his aggression. You know, he played against us. I saw him playing. He played home and away both the games. So he was really aggressive, and the way he was fighting. Though they are losing, but he never gave up. I like that attitude of his. You know, and he's very skillful, and he's been scoring goals, and he scored against us many a times. He scored some 3 goals against us. You know, and he was really good. So if you want to join the BFC, you have to be mentally strong. because we at this level, the reserve team and all, we just look for those wins. You know, you need to have a winning mentality. That's very important. From the office staff to the management, everybody, we all believe in having that winning mentality. That's very important. So we look for that in a player.
So, you know, you have been a player. I'm sure, like in India, we haven't seen a player like you, because you are the specialist in throw-in. And, you know, when you walk itself, people used to, you know, recognize you by your long locks of hair that you had. And now you're just missing it, I'm sure about it. Like, you know, how did you transfer? Because you were known as a player, like, you know, who are a very fashionable player. And even in the terms, you know, people used to come and watch your throw-in and your long kicks and all that. And now you being a player, and now you be turning as a coach, and especially the players who have played with you, like, for example, Baijing Bhutia and all the big names to add on. So, you know, most of them have not got into the coaching line. They are into their own business and other works and other things. They are occupied in the other field. But you started doing your coaching. You started concentrating on coaching. You are one of the pro licensed coach. So how was this transformation from a player to a coach?
You know, I joined Air India in 1992 when they were playing. And then what happened was, I was getting job offers, you know, by 1994, I got into the national team, and then a lot of job offers, everything was coming in. And then I was not taking the jobs, because during those days, jobs were very important for the players. You know, you take a job, be secured, because the contract was not that big. No, it was just compared to now, it was nothing. It was peanuts. You know, so most of the players were taking up jobs and all and getting settled and, you know, being secure. But I never wanted to relax. So I always wanted to take it as a challenge that, you know, I wanted to play for all the big clubs, play for the country and keep going, keep working hard. And during those days itself, you know, when I was 22, 23, that's when I had made up my mind, what after football? Because I used to have a lot of arguments with my dad. You know, who himself was to say take up a job, because be secure, you don't know about football. And 94, it happened, like, you know, I was with the pre-Olympic team and qualifying rounds, and I injured my knee and I had to get operated, and I was out for a year. You know, that's when again my dad told me, why don't you take up a job? No, I don't want to, because this is what I want to do. You know, if I had a job, maybe I would not have worked that hard to recover and get back into fitness and, you know, do the same thing. Maybe I would have been like other players, I had a job, henna, no problem, you know. So that really pushed me, you know. And during those days itself, I had made up my mind, I want to play football. What after football? I want to be a coach. You know, during those days only I started, I was lucky to play under a lot of good coaches. In Air India, I had Bimal Ghosh. Then I went to Churchill Brothers, where I had Danny McLean, who played for Celtic and all. And he was a big influence for me to get into coaching. The way he used to take his sessions, and the way he used to motivate, and the way he used to talk, the way he used to plan the games and all. So after that, I went to East Bengal, where I had PK Banerjee, then I had Manoranjan Bhattacharya. Then I was with the national team with Akramal, Naeem Sir. All these coaches really influenced me a lot. And then that's when I started preparing myself to be a coach.
Okay. So
it was not that, you know, just by luck or something I became a coach. No, it was planned. like we say, you need to have a short-term plan and a long-term plan. So it's very important how you plan yourself, you know, how you plan your future. And you work towards it. You just don't sit and say that this is going to happen. It won't happen. You need to work towards it.
And what about the team? You follow any particular team where you follow their formations and things? Because, you know, I seriously follow more of Barcelona. But yes, now I have changed my position, I think, after seeing the Liverpool and Manchester City game.
Yeah. No, what happens is, as a coach, every game is important, you know. You like to see Barcelona for the tiki-taka way. you know, and then there are new ways coming in. So it's very important. It's very important, you as a coach, how you analyze the game, how, in what way you're looking at the game. You know, I don't have a favorite team. I really don't have any favorite team. Yeah, but when I was my playing days, I used to like Bayern Munich. I used to watch them a lot because that's when those days we didn't have enough star sports and all. You know, it was more of Doordarshan. So we used to get those German league and Italian leagues. That's when I got to see more of Italian players. And that's where I got into Maldini. That's what as I said, I don't follow any particular team or I have a favorite team. Yes, as you said, Manchester City, Liverpool. See, these are the teams who are playing good brand of football, more ball position, because modern football is all about that, you know, having the ball. So you learn. Now you see Sarri, he did a great work at Chelsea and now with Juventus. So he was with Napoli also, and I was following him as well, because the way he because if you hear Pep Guardiola, he also says how good Sarri is as far as ball position is concerned. You know, he's tactically very good. So as a coach, yes, I need to watch all the games in particular game in what I want to learn, what I want to get out of a particular game. You know. Say like if I want to have learn something about ball position, how the wingers are moving, how the midfielders are moving, how the strikers give position and how they are working on it. So it all depends on that. What exactly you want out of a game, what you want to learn out of a game.
So, you know, right now in India, when we saw the Indian team playing also, we missed the throw-in from you. You know, there's no player like, you know, who takes a throw-in like you. So what was the technique that you used? And, you know, now Liverpool also has brought in a special coach for the throw-in itself. So, you know, actually that is, again, one of the advantages that a team has in a scoring, in a position point of view thing, right? So, you know, because of that, So, can you share with us the techniques of throw-in? Because there are many players and young coaches who are there. And, you know, they can start taking it up seriously and start training. Because nobody, I haven't seen any of the coaches who have done coaching for throw-in.
Of course, any set piece is important. But what you need to understand is how many throw-ins you get in a game. You know, how many throw-ins you get in a game and how many you get in the attacking third. You know, you can get many throw-ins in the mid third or the defensive third, you get many throw-ins, but still how many you get, and then do you really need to coach that? You know, it was nobody coached me how to throw. Maybe it was in Bonn. If you see me, I was very lanky and I'm still lanky. You know, I'm not that muscular or something that I have that power to, but it was in Bonn and it was God gift to me. So what I do is like if I see any of my players doing that, so then I work on him. You know, you cannot have all the 10 players doing that. If I had that, I would not have been that famous. You know, because people know me for my throw-ins. People know me for my throw-ins. You know, so yes, again, I need to look for that talent. If I have, I. Yes, so last year I had one Rafi and I have Parag who's good at throwing, and then I have another from the under 18 I have one or two players. So I'm working on them, you know, I just give them the technique how the ball can go more further. So it's all about the grip, you know, the ball. If you have a good grip, then the ball is going much ahead. You know, if the ball is more slippery, you can't throw long. So my playing days also, you know, I would always try to keep some cloth or something, you know, just to keep my hands dry, so that I get a good grip. So again, it's again as I said in the beginning, how many throw-ins you get, you know, it's not much, but yes, you need to look for those one or two players who can do that. In that attacking third where you can have long throw-ins, and if you see the senior team, we have Rahul BK And then you have this Parag now. He just got promoted from the reserve team to the senior team. He again is good. He has good throw-ins, you know. So I'm sure Carlos would like to have him in the team and work on him. He's young. So definitely in one or two years he should really make it big there, and you will see the throw-ins there.
As a coach, qualities and attitude do you expect from a player, sir?
If you as a coach, you see that player is very low. But again, you have to understand a lot of things, you know, because there are players who have quality, but they have some psychological problem as well. So you as a coach, it's very important how you assess the player, his qualities and all. Then yes, you have a good player who's technically good, he has everything in him, but he's not disciplined. Then how you handle it? Then you have a player who's technically good, he does everything well, he's hardworking, he's disciplined also, but psychologically he's not good. No, so you have to see all the aspect of the player, of the situation, you know, and then you have to handle accordingly. But yes, as you asked, like, what are the attributes? It's very simple. But at BFC for the youths, what, you know, a lot of people ask, you know, what is the secret for success? They keep asking, what is this? And it's very simple. To be successful, you have to be disciplined, hardworking, you know, there are many things. But you should know, it's something you should know to handle, you know, that is your failure. You know, and we need to understand why I fail repeatedly, why I keep giving a bad performance or a bad result or whatever. So what we teach here at BSC is to handle the failure, you know, to be away from fear. You know, the secret of failure is fear. So we at BSC, we see that, you know, the kids are courageous. They take their own decision, they just want to go all the time. Then only the winning mentality comes. So once that fear is out of not performing well and all, I think you're successful in life, no matter what you're doing. Because if you see, Kalpana, example, if I'll give you, we go for our A license exam, we have a practical exam and all, you know.
You know, take in my case, you know, because I work with IWL teams. And, you know, few teams give me a free hand, like, you know, Pune City and all had given me a free hand to work with the players. But there are times, you know, where the management puts so much of pressure that, you know, you have to sacrifice the confident level. Some players, you know that they will really, you know, outcast the skills over there. But management comes and says, no, you should not play over there. You should play some other players. So, you know, this type of situation he's asking about.
Just once, it was.
I know you bad, have but, been you know, lucky enough that you have been given a free hand to operate, I think, so far.
Yeah, I've been lucky on that, you know. But only thing was when I joined Pune FC in 2013. You know, that's when I got the team. I didn't make the team. You know, I got the set of boys, and I had already worked with Mumbai FC, and I was the runners-up for the I League. You know. So I know the level of under-19 I League then. So I saw this team and I told the management that this team cannot give you that result, what you're asking for. You know, it won't help. So till the end of the season, it was going on. And, you know, I had another mentor, Mr. Ranjan Chaudhary, you know, learned a lot from him because he was always at you, you know. Because he wanted us to grow, you know. So there was a lot of fights, we had a lot of discussion, debates, you know. That was his way of teaching you, you know. Even he would never say do this or do that, you know. He would go in the other way to challenge you, you know. So that's when towards the end of the season, I kept requesting, no, this team won't work. So what happened was, this is going on record. So And yeah, this is what our coach life is, you know. This is what our coach life is. If you give result, you are there, otherwise you are sacked. So it all depends on the players you have and the kind of players you want to give that particular result. So that's when what I did was I had a squad of 25 players. I just kept 3 players. I asked all the players to go. And I just called up my CEO and I told him, I want to meet you. I didn't even speak to Ranjan sir. You know, he also don't know about it. He had no idea about it, you know. So I just spoke to my CEO. I told him, I want to meet you. I traveled to Mumbai. I had a meeting with him. He said, yeah, tell me what happened. Mala, this is what I did. He was like, what? I said, yeah, it's that. If you want result, give me one year. I will bring the players. If I don't give result, I leave the job. You don't have to sack me. I will go out of. And that's when that year we were the runners up in I League. No, we lost to the Indian team, India under 19. Not lost, we drew with them. And that's how, with points, we were down. You know, so that was the, because I'm a guy who's more. I never go for debates or arguments. So that was the only time it was really tough for me to go and fight with Mr. Ranjan sir. You know, but again, I'm in touch with him. We talk, we meet, you know. He has high regards. I have high because I've learned a lot from him.
Yeah, so we have a question from Girish Desai. Girish is from Pune. So he has a question. He says, how do you deal with players having attitude?
As I said in the beginning, I told you about Pune where I learned from Ranjan sir. Everybody needs to have attitude. It's very important. That attitude, now again, it's a positive attitude or negative attitude, right? So there are players with positive attitude and there are players. When Girish is talking about attitude, I'm sure he's talking about players being indisciplined, not listening to the coach, right? So now it's very important for you as a coach, how you deal with it, how you deal with the situation, you know. At BFC we have fines, at the senior team we have good amount of fine, with the reserve team it goes less, you know, for indiscipline, for being abusive or doing bad things at the ground, not doing well, you know, being indisciplined, fighting with the players. So all these things, we have fines for the players. So Girish is talking about negative attitude, yeah. So again, you as a coach, you play a big role. How you take him, now why he has that negative attitude, it's very important for you to understand. You have to see his psychological part, why he is doing that. You know, why he is showing that negative attitude. Is there any problem at home or maybe he has a girlfriend or whatever. It can be anything personal. So it's very important to understand. Now I'll give you a small example. I had a player who went to the national team and he came back. He went to the, I don't want to name the player. So he just came back and he was not able to perform. You know, he was so low. So, and he's a good player. He's a very good player, very talented player. And it took him two months to come out of it. It was not only, I thought maybe, you know, he was out, he got injured. He was not out because of his bad performance. He was out because he had an ankle injury. But again, he started training. But again, he was low only. Then I had to sit with him. I had to speak to him because I thought he might come over it. I thought maybe he was not in the team or he got injured and all. That's why he came out. But when I spoke to him, I got to know his younger brother was into a wrong line, you know. He was not doing well, troubling the family and all. So all this thing was troubling him, and okay. that was the result for his bad performance. So when I spoke to him, I got to understand. So after that, he was top class. He was playing all most of the games he has played for me. Only two or three games he was out because of injury. So again, the negative attitude, you have to understand, you need to sit with the player and talk. You know, it's not only players with negative attitude, you have to talk with every player and especially the youngsters, because there are a lot of things happening in their mind at this age. they are going through a lot of things. It can be anything, and you have to be a person they should speak freely with, you know. If not me, I see that my assistant is helping me on that, you know. I see that he goes and speak to the players, they are free to him, because there are players who are scared of me, you know, and you won't believe, my friends, they laugh, you know, when I tell them the players are scared of me. They're scared of you. Like, yeah.
Yeah, even I also laugh for this. Yeah.
No, but on the pitch, I'm very bad. I'm the other way. I'm very aggressive there. So maybe, I don't know.
Thank you so much for being with us, and thank you, viewers. I'm sure, like, you know, it was a good time that you had with Naushad, our coach, one of our favorite player and a coach also, and who has, you know, been with us and who has educated you all in whatever questions that you all have asked. And apart from that, he's given a lot of ideas for you all to become as a better coach and better players. So please implement it. And thank you, Naushad. And thank you, viewers.
Thank you so much, Kalpana. Thank you so much, Kalpana. And thank you, everyone over here, who patiently listen to me. Thank you so much.